good morning. Have you ever worked and there was no pay or there was no reward? This week we've been talking about prayer and the call to pray. And I believe that you have taken time, you know, even to engage and communicate with God. And so today we're going to see the rewards of prayer. And my key scripture comes from the book of James, chapter 5 and verse 16. The Bible says that the earnest prayers of a righteous person has great power and produces wonderful results. Glory to God. Now, repeatedly, Jesus encouraged his disciples to believe that the Heavenly Father is a prayer-hearing and a prayer-answering God. He compares the Heavenly Father with our earthly fathers. And when you look at the book of Luke chapter 11 and verse 13, Jesus asked, "If you then, though you are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father in heaven give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him?" Amen. I have three rewards or three benefits that come with prayer. And my first benefit is this, that we experience forgiveness. We experience forgiveness when we pray. Remember, we have all sinned, and there are days and moments we fall and we want someone to lift us up, to forgive our sins, to walk right. The only one who can help us do that is Christ Jesus. And we receive salvation and the forgiveness of sin when we confess our sins unto the Lord. And he is able to forgive us. The Bible says, that, listen, this is what the Bible says, that everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. And then 1 John chapter 1 verse 19, verse 9 says, "But if we confess our sins to him, he is faithful and just to give us, to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from all wickedness." I want to walk right. I want to live a righteous life. Who's able to do it? God. But it comes with when we confess our sins to him, even as we pray. The second benefit of prayer is that God gives us wisdom. Wisdom to live life, wisdom to do business, wisdom to have the best of the best experiences of life. And the Bible says in James chapter 1 and verse 5 that if anyone of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to you. Why are we asking for wisdom? Because we want to walk right, we want to do right, we want to live right, and we want to have the best. And the wisdom of God directs us, but we need to ask and pray. And the last thing is that we receive the power of the Holy Spirit even as we pray. As I have read Luke chapter 11 and verse 13, the Bible has said that will God refuse you to give the Holy Spirit unto you? It's amazing, as we live life and we allow God and we allow the Holy Spirit to take over, and the Holy Spirit takes over our lives and fulfills God's purposes through us. This comes from an intimate relationship of prayer with God, when you request from him and he provides. Today, what is it that you need? Do you need forgiveness of sin? Confess it unto the Lord. Do you need wisdom to live life? Ask the Lord and he'll give you. Do you need the power of the Holy Spirit? God is there to give you when you ask, when you pray. So in conclusion, this is what we say, that a believer who departs from the day's work without first finding or first getting time to talk to God is like a soldier who departs for battle without weapons. By prayer, we check in with the Heavenly Father and we check in with the headquarters in heaven. It is in the experience of prayer that the Heavenly Father communicates what he wishes us, what he wishes to, you know, what he wishes for us. Glory to God. It is when we pray that he is able to communicate to us. It is when we are able to communicate to him. So do not take it for granted that even in this time and even in this season and this hour that you're being called to pray. Take some time and pray. Take some time and inquire from the Lord. Heavenly Father, thank you for a wonderful time we've had, even discussing and sharing about prayer. We pray for the grace of God. Much more so, Lord, we pray, O King of Glory, that you may help us to walk in the path of righteousness. Glory to God. Father, Lord, we also pray for wisdom to do life. And we pray for the power of the Holy Spirit, even in us, Jehovah King of Glory, for us to be able to fulfill your purposes and your will. Thank you, O King of Glory, for this channel that is open for us to be able to communicate with you through prayer. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Amen. Have a great day. God bless you.